Hey everyone, today we're doing integration using substitution with examples and solutions and including trig substitution. Alright, so this was voted by you guys in three maths groups, so I hope you enjoy. Let's get into it. Alright, first off, let's just do a quick clarification. A lot of students have this trouble, is what is integration by substitution and why do we need it? Well, integration by substitution is when we have questions that we can't integrate straight away, they look a bit tricky, a bit nasty. So what do? We use a substitution to transform the integral into something that's much easier. So that's the what and the why. Why? Because it makes it much easier to integrate. All right, so let's get kick off with an example. Okay, so let's look at this example. The integral from 0 to 1 of x bracket x squared plus 5 to the power of 5 dx using the substitution u equals x squared plus 5. Alright, so normally most beginner level they'll give you the substitution, right? But you can normally determine what one you want. So what's the first step? Alright, so step 1, let's find du on dx. So to do that, we differentiate this, so the derivative of x squared is just 2x. And then we want to make dx a subject because that means we can do a straight substitution for dx here. Right? I find this way is better instead of doing the other way that it's taught. This way is a lot easier. It's a direct substitution. You don't have to manipulate x dx equals du. Find it a bit easier. So here, dx, so all we're going to do is swap them, right? Dx will be du on 2x, right? I just swap dx with 2x and that's, I just directly substitute that into there. So step 2. Now we have bounds. So all we have to do is we have to transform the bounds to match the substitution. So if x equals 1, that means u will be 1 plus 5 equals 6. Right? Sub into there. And then when x equals 0, u will be 0 plus 5 equals 5. Okay. So now, step 3, sub everything in. So sub our substitution, sub our bounds, and sub dx. So the bounds are now, whoops, my bad, didn't see that, 5. So 5 to 6, x, that's now u to the power of 5, because that's our u, times du on 2x. So what happens here is once you sub it in, the x's should cancel out. So now my integral is just u to the power 5 on 2, between 5 and 6 du. Now an extra step, if the x's don't cancel out and it's still the next there, what you'll have to do is use a substitution to sub x in, which I'll look at in the next example. So now the next step, now this is the easiest step, is just to integrate this. So you can see this looks really messy, like, well, how do you integrate it? But then look at this, u to the power 5. That's just the beginner level, right? Add 1 to the power, divide by the new power. But when we divide by 6, that becomes 12. And now we just sub in 6 and 5. So then the last step is sub your bounds in, if you need to. So I don't have to calculate me, but we'll sub it in. We get 6 to the power of 6 minus 5 to the power of 6 over 12. So whatever that equals, just plug into the calculator, we're done. Now, an additional step, if we did not have bounds to sub in, is, which I'll show you in the next example, is we'd have to sub u for the x back in, right? We're gonna sub this back in at the end and add a plus c, okay? So let's look at an example that does that. All right, a next example, integral of x over square root x plus 1 dx using u equals x plus 1. So let's follow the same process. First, let's get du on dx, which is easy, that's just 1. So then that means du equals dx. There are no bounds to sub in, so I can just go directly to substituting in everything. So x stays there because it's not a part of u, over square root u, because u is x plus 1 and dx is just du. So this is what I was talking about, after your substitution, you still have an x left. So to get rid of this now, we go back to the original substitution. And x equals u minus 1, right? So we're going to make x the subject, and now sub that in. Because we need everything in terms of u to integrate it. So this is just u minus 1 over, and look what I'm doing here to help me. I'm going to write that as a half. Right, so square root u is just u to the power of a half. So to integrate this now, it might look a bit tricky, but reason why this is better than this is a single numerator with multiple terms. Now this is a denominator with one term, so I can split the fraction. So I can split this as u over u to the half minus 1 over u to the half. And then if we collect the powers, so 1 minus 1/2, that's integral of u to the half, and that's minus u to the negative 1/2 du. So now this is in the form I can just integrate term by term. So we add 1 to the power, divide by the new power. Add 1 to the power, divide by the new power, and we're going to chuck our plus c. So if we clean this up, this is what I was talking about. If we don't have bounds, we've got to sub u back for what it was. So then if I clean this up in one go, this fraction flips, using that x plus 1 to the power 3 on 2, minus 2, this fraction flips, x plus 1 to the power of 1/2, plus c. Right. So those two examples cover most integration by substitution questions. Let's look at one last type with trig substitution. We need a bit of extra help for those. Alright, one last example, but using trig substitution. Integral of dx over x squared brackets or square root 1 minus x squared using x equals cos theta. So, no matter what kind of substitution, follows the same process, except the integrating step here is going to require a bit more effort using trig knowledge. So if we sub, well first we find what dx on the theta is. So that gives me negative sine theta. So dx is just negative sine theta d theta. So I sub that in. So here's the difference that when we're using trig substitution, we don't do du on d theta. We're going to find dx on d theta now because we have x equals. So we sub everything in. Dx is negative sine theta d theta. And a good thing about these trig substitutions is because it's x equals, you can just directly substitute x for that. We don't need to do the step of making u the subject we did in the last example. So that's just cos squared theta square root 1 minus cos squared theta. Okay? So this is where I said we need our trig knowledge to help us. Right? If you don't have any basic trig knowledge, this integral doesn't look any better than that. But the trick with all these ones is they always use the Pythagorean identity. Right? But this is what I'm talking about. So cos squared plus sine squared equals 1. Right, because we're doing cos, we want this one. So if you notice, 1 minus cos squared will be sine squared. And this is why these substitutions are really great, is because now the square root is gone. Alright. Cos squared theta, sine theta, d theta. And then the sines just cancel. So I'm left with integral negative 1 on cos squared theta d theta. Alright, so that integral looks way better now. Alright, but still done. I still can't integrate it in that form, right? Having trig functions in the denominator makes them hard to integrate. But this is where you need to know more. Again, your trig knowledge, reciprocal functions. 1 over cos is sec theta. So this is just the integral of negative sec squared theta d theta, and that's a dead easy integral, right? If you know your formula, the standard integral table, the integral of sec squared is tan theta. So this is just negative tan theta plus c. So we've done the integral. So, but trig substitution requires one further step if there's no bounds. Right? If there's bounds, we would have subbed them in and that would have been easy. But to sub this back into terms of the original x, it's not a direct substitution because we have x equals cos theta, but this is tan. So what we do is we draw a right angle triangle using the substitution. So cos theta equals x would be x and 1, right? Because cos is adjacent over hypotenuse. So x over 1 will give you x. And then we use Pythagoras to get the other side, which would be root 1 minus x squared, right? That squared minus that squared, square rooted. So then the integral is just, what's tan theta? We'll just go to the triangle. Opposite over adjacent. And plus c. And there, that's the answer, right? So trig substitutions require a few bit of extra knowledge. You need your identities. And at the end, you need to draw the right angle triangle to work it sub back in, all right? So I hope you enjoyed this tutorial on integration by substitution. We did a couple examples, including the trig sub. So this was a topic voted by you. So if you want next Wednesday's topic to be voted by, or the topic you want, make sure to go to my free maths help group. And also leave comments below what you want, right? Because then I take your comments and we vote in my maths free maths group in Facebook on what topic should be my video, right? So the link to that is in the description. Always make sure to subscribe to get more awesome content.